Neil, you go take the lead, we'll do it.
Commissioner Thursby did indicate, Mayor, that he was on the way to the chamber, for sure. Well, good afternoon. First item today is the only item in reference to the 2017-2018 budget. It's our first meeting that we've had with staff and with full commission. Today, what we want to do is we want to present to you the draft budget to you as a whole. That does include most of the wish list items for the upcoming 2017-2018 fiscal year. A few housekeeping items first. To adopt our budget does require two public hearings. They are scheduled for September the 14th at 5:01 p.m. They do have to be at 5 o'clock. And the second is on September the 26th at 5:01. Both will be held at the commission chambers at 2775 Beerson. As it sits today, your enterprise funds, if you'll turn over to page 7 to your agenda package you have, the enterprise funds, which includes your water, sewer, and solid waste, are currently balanced on there right now. You know, that's put in there just the first day of the budget process. The general fund is currently out of about $78,000. This is utilizing your current business rate, 3.5914. If you recall, we did send back to the property appraiser at a millage rate of 4.5914, 1 mil increase to begin the budgetary process. That number can always come down if it doesn't need to go back up. And so basically what we're going to do is, at this point, I'm going to turn it over to Mr. McCord. We're going to start on page 1, and we're going to go through the big points, or moving points of the budget itself, and then we're going to narrow the process down to go through each one of the funds for you. So at any point in time, we need to stop and ask questions. Now's the time for the board to start getting into the budget process. Thank you. Mr. Cooler.
Thank you, Jim. As Jim stated, the current balance in the general fund is out of balance by about $78,000. We have had a couple of minor changes to that have occurred. First of all, we got some firm numbers from the state on our revenue sharing numbers. And so that reduced the debt about $3,000. And then we had some staffing changes that we made. So right now, we're at about $69,000 variance in the general fund based on those changes that were made today. And so then we'll just go through the budget review items. The first item lists the ad valorem tax. Our current millage rate is 3.5914. And based on the estimates for the ad valorem base increase in property values, we're estimated to see about a $44,000 increase in our general fund revenues without changing our current millage. And if you were to elect to raise the millage, a quarter point amounts to approximately $70,000 in additional revenue. So with that, we'll go to the outstanding issues. We just discussed the current ad
valorem.
Yes, go ahead, please.
I just wanted to go on record that I'm not looking to raise taxes. We haven't raised taxes in over 10 years, and I think we can do other things to make our budget balance instead of raising taxes. Yeah. On the record.
It's great. We certainly can balance the budget without raising our taxes. And as we do every year, we put in a request to for a possible rate increase in case our health insurance comes back with extremely high numbers or our property taxes are raised. But we've gotten good news on both of those fronts, so those fronts aren't going to be an issue. So we certainly can balance the budget with some decisions to be made with the current millage rate. And speaking of good news, we've already discussed the current ad valorem rates. The second item is the health insurance. The budget that we calculated, I had a 3% increase in the health insurance costs across the boards, and those numbers came in at 2.91% increase. So we were very pleased to see a minimal increase in our health insurance. But that does leave us with some decisions to make about the health insurance and the cap. And whether or not we're going to leave the cap at 705 or whether we're going to raise it to the 71402, which is the new rate for that health insurance plan option number one.
So they would completely offset that, I'm guessing.
Well, as you remember, last year we had two options. We had health insurance plan one and health insurance plan two. Health insurance plan one was under the 705 cap amount, so the employees didn't pay anything. Health insurance plan two was over the cap amount, and employees pay about $45 a month for that coverage, which had the better deductible and co-pays on it. So if we leave the cap at 705, then employees are going to have to cover the cost of approximately $9 a month for health insurance plan one, and employees would have to then pay $54 a month for health insurance plan two.
And that's just essentially the better coverage, so if they want to leave that better.
Right. So the increase from the we were paying $693 a month per employee. Now the new rate is at 714. That amounts to about a $13,000 increase in costs if we were decision was made to elect the cap, to raise the cap to $714.02. So that's the first big decision as far as staff is concerned, is the health insurance cap.
What would that equate to in a year?
Well, if we raise the cap, our total cost would be $13,000 to cover that additional cost, as opposed to leaving the cap at 705.
Well, it's certainly not very much, but the last 2 years we said we're going to cap, we didn't cap, we're going to cap, we didn't cap, but let's get to a point when they have to. $9 doesn't sound like too much, but with our budget, it amounts to $13,794.
Right. And that's across all funds.
Yeah.
That's spread out.
And with the cost of living increase, that's supposed to cover some of the things that go up.
So that would be the first bit of business we need guidance on, is whether to leave the cap at 705 or raise it to that 714. So that's where we are with the health insurance. Good news overall with the rate increase. Then that would take us down to number five, the liability and workers' comp insurance. We received excellent bids on those numbers. We worked on approximately $280,000 a year with Florida Lee, and those numbers came in from $220,000. Up to 260, and we're reviewing those numbers now, and we haven't gotten a firm answer yet from Dwight as to whether or not we're comfortable with the lowest bid of, or the lowest quote of 220.
He currently has those under review, spoke with him yesterday, and plans to have something to us in the next week.
So we worked 260 into this budget just as a hold or placeholder, which is $20,000 less than what we had last year. So we may see some savings there, and we should certainly know by the next budget meeting what those numbers, and bring that to the next commission. We may have it for the next commission meeting.
We'll bring it to you soon.
Last year's numbers and previous, what were they, 280s?
Yeah, it was 280,000 to the Florida League, and I believe the League was the highest quote of the.
No, that actually it was second.
It was second.
So we could possibly save $60,000 there.
Correct.
I want to commend Commissioner Ashford. He worked hard on that. I know I had a little bit to do with it, but I know he went out further. So that, I mean, we're going to save some money there.
And that would be spread across the fund, the fund. So we certainly could see some savings there.
When you say spread across the funds, how is that broke down? Is it a percentage?
I didn't calculate that, but it's based on several different factors, like the vehicles, the number of vehicles in each department of the property, a lot of our properties in recreation,
know, and so a lot of it's general fund, so it varies. And I don't have that number for you, but I certainly can put that.
Yeah, the next meeting, I mean, it would be easier since the debt that we're deficient in the general fund, what these numbers would mean on that fund.
On the general fund side, yes, sir. I can put those numbers together as soon as we get it.
So any questions or comments on the first five items? All right, then we'll move on to salaries. The employee salary COLA currently in the budget is 3%, which equates to $78,000, approximately $78,000 across funds for an employee cost of living increase. The next item then is the employee merit raises. As you can see listed in the staffing changes section, you list the merit raises as 4 merit raises listed there. And then the fifth one is actually a certification upgrade. So if the employee passes certification from C to B, there's a dollar, automatic dollar raise in that salary. So that's number 7 is the employee.
Well, you may have more than one taking the test and advancing also, which
I'm not sure. I can check with department heads.
That's the only one we know of at this point. Yes, sir. There could be somebody else that's qualified. I don't know if anybody else qualified. Most of the folks already have one in Larry's job, and they're.
And they got, it's been a year before our new guy.
But I'm talking about one from C to B or B to A.
Yes.
I mean, you may have something that.
So we try to anticipate those costs and work them in into the budget.
Okay.
Then item 8 is a commission merit raise, which amounts to $58,000 approximately in salaries. And after review, it does not include the calculation for taxes and retirement pay. So the total impact loaded as on the proposed merit raise for commission is $70,000.
I just want to put it out there that I actually asked you and Jim at the meeting with you guys to put that in there. I've gotten several compliments on as far as us getting ourselves raised. I put it out there to see where the board was at and for discussion. We can do it, we can't do it, whatever. I mean, it's in there, so.
Certainly, from my viewpoint, it's certainly been overdue that we haven't had a raise for city commissioners in a while. It was 1997 that it was established at $300 a month, and there's been minimal change since then, or no change since then. You know, that's out there. It's in the budget now. It's up for discussion.
Well, I appreciate you bringing that to us for discussion, but I really can't support when we've got a $78,000 deficit right off the top. I think we need to stay where we are and try to balance this budget. And that's a quick way to do it, a quick, easy way to do it. We haven't had any raises in a while, but I mean, I don't think you put a dollar on public service, so that's my feelings on it. It's just one of many, but it's my comments.
Mike, I'd just like to say I appreciate Brett for putting that in there. I did some research, school board members, their salary is $25,480 a year. County commissions $27,640. Both of these guys have one meeting a month. There's many times we've had 2, sometimes 5 meetings a month. I know this, and I knew right up front that Commissioner Bazette would probably not be for it, but I am for it, and the people that I've talked to, they're my supporters, all believe it's well overdue. Thank you.
Oh, I was just saying to it that
I don't want to cause us to have to raise the taxes for us to get a raise. But again, I think if we go through the budget, I think there's other places we can save money. And so, and I have had a lot of people that voted for me, said I deserve more money. That's their opinion. They have. I had a lot of people vote for me. So that's where I'm at.
Well, one thing a lot of people probably may not realize is, I mean, we get $300 a month salary, but you also get your health insurance paid for it, so it's amounts of $1,000 a month. It's not counting a little bit of retirement that the city has to kick in for. So you know, doubling is quite a bit, doubling what we got.
Yes, sir.
Let me say one more thing. Most of us have had one born with our silver spoon. We had parents that really had to work. I know I did. We barely got by. Barely. So yeah, I can see one man needs money. Maybe somebody has money all their life can't see that. But I can't, because I've been in a poorhouse. With my family, in the first early years of my marriage, I was in a poorhouse. I had to juggle bills. I had to figure out which bill this week I can't pay. Some people never have to do that. Never. They've always got money to pay their bills. Well, some of us on this commission do not. And we're doing a good job. Some people may not think we are, but the majority of the people think we are. So.
Well, we certainly have that amount in the budget now, and we'll change it or adjust it in your discretion.
You know, I'll echo one thing the mayor said. I'm not for this at all if it means raising taxes. I'm not going to put that burden on the citizens, but if we can make it work another way, I'm not against it.
Well, we certainly can go through the rest of the budget and see where it falls out and see what decisions we have to make overall in order to balance.
You know,
I want to say this, it really had nothing to do with how you raise or what kind of money you had here or there. That's not the issue we're talking about. It has nothing to do with that. We're not up here. You don't run for this job to make a living.
I never have.
And so it has nothing to do with it. You had money in the past, you didn't have money in the past. I just want to say that.
Yes, sir.
I think last, again, we heard this. I heard it from, and apparently you heard it from your voters. That's why it's in there.
All right, with that, then we'll move on. The ninth item is the FRS retirement cost increase. There was a minor increase on the employer's percentage to pay into the retirement for employees. It amounted to a total of about $10,000 estimate that we have to pay into the state. No change to the employee's 3%, but the employers saw some increase into what we kick in for employees' retirement. All right, with that then we'll go through, we've discussed most of the staffing changes, but they're listed there, the employee cost of living, the commissioner merit raise. We'll adjust that number to 70K loaded in the next revision of the budget. Now, in order to help us manage the general fund with that increase, we looked at the allocation of commission salaries. And historically, 100% of those salaries had been booked to general fund. Not sure why. All of the other admin costs are split 50 general fund, 50 enterprise. So to be consistent with the other admin costs, we split the commission salaries and benefits across all four funds.
Is that reflected in this?
That's the city fund allocation salary shift salaries, $69,000. So that's reflected there. So we shifted $69,000 out of the general fund over to the other three funds to be consistent with the same we do for all of our admin staff who deal with multiple pieces of the puzzle. Obviously, you all don't all deal with just general fund issues. People call you with water issues, garbage issues. So to be consistent, and I'm not sure why 100% of it went all to general fund, but to be consistent with the other departments, the other admin salaries, we shifted those expenses.
So with that, we're still 78 in the red.
even with that, we're still so right now we're 69 in the red based on the changes. So that's that category item. The next item is the police department new officer position. It's $55,771. That is loaded for that position. And then there's one merit raise in the police department. Any discussion on that?
Is the new position is in the budget at one time or was it?
It is in the budget currently, yes, sir. The budget you have before you has a new position in the police.
And you lost an officer, right?
We had one turn in his notice on Friday, yes, sir. The one that was given an attaboy at the last meet.
Yeah, I know. Well, you get, $400 more a month?
$4,800 a year raise to go work for the Bay County Sheriff's
Office. Well, and honestly, just to...
And what was the deal on finding a place to live?
Yeah, that's it.
Is it $500 or $800, but it's $1,200?
Yeah.
Something's wrong. Something's wrong over here. People, you should pay more money, don't get it.
Well, it's certainly an indicator we have lost other employees. You know, it's certainly tough to find housing in the area for a young person. Yeah,
we lost four this past month that we've had in the place. So let's go. When the economy's good, people find other jobs. So yeah. It's tough to compete right now. It's
and the affordable housing is.
They're moving in.
Huh?
They're moving
they're
in.
They're already starting to move.
But I mean, this gentleman couldn't find them.
Well, I guess once he found the other job, he wasn't looking for that place.
He's not eligible. If you work for the city, you make too much money to live there.
Yeah.
I mean, if you make more than $13 an hour, you can't live there.
I don't think we have any city employees, unfortunately, that qualify.
Okay, so then we talked about the merit raises and then the upgrade raise. Then the next category would be revenue generators. Boat ramp fees, we are a little low on our boat ramp fees. We have started the process of monthly contacting annual renewals for permits, so people would pay the $50 to renew their boat ramp permits, so we'll continue to do that. Certainly the scallop season service.
We need to send something out on maybe our water bills to our local city residents, and I don't know how we get to the county, but we've got a lot of them that's never come and got their stickers. And if you go down there, you can't call them. It's a tag on the back from Florida, but it says in God we trust. I don't know where they're from. I mean, they got the county there, I know. And because, you know, and I know Commissioner Thursby's not making an agreement with me totally on this, but when we started that boat ramp thing, we said we'd let it go for a couple of years or more. And after that, we would start tightening down and making people pay. My point is, it's not fair for the ones that do pay. The deadbeats not pay. So we've got to do something.
It's a difficult
issue. To make sure we're getting what we're supposed to be getting. Because you know as well as I do, there's a lot of people coming from Bay County. Don't buy nothing here. Just come here, they load it up ready to go, they put the boat in our bay and enjoy our bay, and they don't give us nothing.
It's different.
And that's got to stop. I mean, it's not fair. We're either going to not charge anybody, or we're going to charge everybody except city and county residents. But we need the city and county residents to help us by getting them a sticker so we can identify them as not having to pay. Because, I mean, I would like to get some time in Point Town where we have a code enforcer go down there and just look, and he don't see it. Put a thing on the windowsill said you should pay next time you will be get a fine or something. Give them a chance. If they continue to do it, that's like training your attorneys on Reed Avenue. If they continue to do it, y'all can give them a damn ticket. I'm sorry.
That's probably something we can
do. Well, they're going to do it forever. Just like the boat ramp. They never going to pay some of them unless you make them.
It's probably something we're going to need to workshop to try to come up with some ideas or strategies on how to drive.
Just since we was on boat ramp, I wanted to mention how I felt about it.
Later, I did quit making you turn on.
The marina agreement is going along there. That's $7,200. The Emerald Coast lease is moving along. I don't know if there's any change with that or those two.
It's for a five-year agreement.
On which one is that?
Emerald Coast Dance.
Yes, okay.
The Waste Pro lease, the transfer station, they're still paying that. We did lose the Waste Pro revenue for tonnage that they were paying us for all the waste that went across the transfer station, and now they have their transfer station. So we did lose that revenue. And then the Verizon water tower lease agreement.
Back to the Waste Pro just a minute. You know, I go on percentages. You know, they do 500 stops a day and they miss three. That's not too bad compared. But when they continue to miss people, don't pick up the trash, the route people don't move the routes, that's not our fault. We need to go back to doing these fines that we got in that contract and make them mean to do what they're supposed to do all the time. Don't pay us the money.
I completely agree with you.
It's happening.
Yeah,
Mayor. They're missing home routes.
We got a man right out here. His trash gets missed a lot. You know?
Mayor, I'd like to see us have staff get with Don Butler. I know the county has drafted a letter, a very strong worded letter to Waste Pro. And Jim could also attach the city's problems. He's got a list of all of them. And let's see if we can't maybe renegotiate that contract, get a better rate, save some money there.
Jim, where are we with the lease on Waste Pro? Do you know
when? Jeff, we're just determined. Discussing with legal. I believe we have 2 years left. It was a 5-year agreement. I'll pull it and I'll put it on the agenda for two.
But it ran concurrent with the county, so didn't it?
Yes, sir. It's for 5 years.
Jim, do you see anything wrong with attaching our complaints to the county's letter that they're writing?
You do have in your contract, you do have the ability to assess fines. We do keep up with complaints that we get on a daily basis, and we do have the logs, but you do have that ability in your contract if you want to enforce fines.
I think it's time to start doing that. You know, you and I, over the last year, had a good sit-down meeting with Ralph and Ralph Fields. Seemed like everything got real good for a couple of months. Now we're right back to where we are. One of the biggest phone calls I get on a weekly basis, the trash didn't get picked up, the trash didn't get picked up. It's not rocket science. If you have a route, I mean, they ask for the contract. They made us these promises, now we need to hold the victim of our. So, guys, I mean, I just think we need to start buying them. I try to get their attention, because nothing else has.
I'll pull the contract, I'll give you
the thanks, guys.
So that's all the revenue generators. The next item is a summary on our road bond project. We've got $1.5 million in road bond money. With the county, and we've estimated we have some expenses in the budget of 1.5 to cover Long Avenue. We're not sure still what the event cost will be or how much we can do, but we did try to maximize that $1 million by putting some of our money in the budget in case we need it and to move along.
Just on that, I just want to kind of let the board know, both know, but on the Long Avenue project, the paving, I spoke to Representative Bashir's last week. He's going to have us an update on that, the additional funding that we requested. So we'll see what happens there when he comes and meets with us.
So
that.
So that's something.
I lost the reach out, and that's what he told me too. So we just got to stay on that. I appreciate Frank.
So what would be the source of that additional funding?
DOT funding.
So that's something we might need to work in the budget then.
Let's just hear what he's got to say. We made the request this past year based on some additional funding he said that he could get us.
And those are washed funds, so it's a grant basically.
Exactly.
It'd be a wash to the net impact, it'd be a revenue and expense.
Right.
But that's something we should work in to the budget.
We did speak with Mr. Smallwood too. We need to have a workshop probably in about 3 weeks once our bids come in for the water line replacement. So then we can put all these pieces of puzzle together. Hopefully, we can have some information on the road payment as well.
Okay. We did submit our first request for reimbursement from the county on that road bond money, and that's in the works now, and we'll let you know how that proceeds. And that was basically for engineering costs on the project. All right, so then that completes page one. Page two is the general fund capital expenses. The police car, the police department has a standard grant of $13,000, and that's additional funding for another vehicle over and above that $13,000, about $28,000 for another vehicle.
Can you get that loaded up, ready to go for 28,000? A new police vehicle?
We can.
All the bells and whistles that we normally put on the decals.
We did go a little bit over that.
We can. This year we did go a little bit over because our grant, we actually applied for a four-wheel drive truck. And it was about 30, but we can make it work at 28. I mean, we have found ways. We don't buy them quit.
Well,
we can make 28 work.
How many vehicles we have is not in service now?
We have two.
One can't be put in service.
Well, one of them is an Impala that the sheriff's office gave us. It doesn't have a radio, and it's not reliable. The other one's a Crown Vic. It's reliable, but it's a 2008.
And from a maintenance perspective, it needs to be replaced. We see those two Crown Vics walk.
If you look at our budget this year, I mean, we've spent a lot of money on vehicle repairs.
Right.
I mean, we've got four cars that are 2010s, and we got two that are 2008s. So, I mean, it's just a matter of time.
I know there was one you were wanting to keep as a while back, as I guess a decoy.
That's what we use in Impala Park. Park at the boat ramp. I mean, it's got lights and stripes, but we park it wherever around town we need to. But it's not, it won't make it through a 12-hour shift and running.
Appreciate it. And the fire department has two capital items, the hose and winders and nozzles, and then additional escrow for the fire engine. That would put it at about $134,000 in escrow. With this 22, that would put it at $134,000 in escrow towards a new fire engine. Our thoughts were to look at maybe next budget cycle after this one at possibly pulling the trigger and being able to buy a fire engine and using and having $22,000 a year to pay the payments on it.
I love doing projects like that. I mean, we talked about it a little bit, Jim, but a five-year capital improvement type, I guess capital improvement schedule, but it'd be a capital improvements budget, you know, but it works out, you know, over the five-year period when you know you're going to be able to afford it.
And we have that worked into our rate study for the enterprise funds, but not in the general fund. I did put that together for you, and I'm sorry I failed to bring that to the meeting today. But we did put together a five-year plan we'll bring to the next meeting, and we can look at that.
For additional items?
For additional items and all the wish list items that departments have looked at down the road for general items that are not in.
Yeah.
Large ticket items that we have worked into our rate study, smaller items, but still items that we need to repair and replace and restock and so forth. So we did put that together, and I will bring that to you in the next, I'll put it in boxes for you to review before the next meeting.
Fire trucks aren't cheap. You know, make sure we got to be conscious of our ISO rating because it affects every one of us on our house insurance. So we got to make sure that we do everything we can. We know we can't afford one every 2 or 3 years, but we start to put our money away, and next year we're more than likely going to ask you to buy a fire truck.
John Ford make it back yet?
Yes, he did.
We do have one fire truck that's getting maintenance done. We need to take it back to Nebraska. So you just can't take it down to the local mechanic to get it worked on.
And he tore blame on the way there, didn't he?
Yes.
He was stranded.
Then the next Department of Streets and Highways, we talked about the road bond money. And then John's got a Ford F-350 and Skag mowers. As you know, he has a construction work crew, and we're pulling big equipment around, and he needed a bigger vehicle to handle that. Also worked into the budget and enterprise as a trailer to go along with that big truck to haul his equipment around to help him to more efficiently handle all of these large construction projects that he is handling. Then recreation is fireworks, the Centennial Building grant, our match on that, the Stack House, the Washington Gym, Christmas lights, entrance sign, and then potential FERDAPs that we may request. And we listed Benny Roberts Sports Park on that.
On the Centennial Building grant, we've got matching in there, but we haven't gotten a grant for that, have we?
No, and it's just like last year, we worked it into the budget, and we put $50,000 match in there, because if we do get the grant, we're going to have to come up with a match. And we...
Are we competing again this year with on that?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, with the VA.
We go next month for the review of the grants.
And 100% of that $31,000 comes out of general, is that correct?
Well, that would be, that's how it is now, yes. I mean, it's a general fund expense. The Centennial Building is categorized as a recreation department, general fund.
Could we use that $31,000 to help our bottom line, and if we receive the grant, put $31,000 into it for BP funds?
Right, we could probably just about do away with that as long as we're competing.
I mean, because there's no guarantee that it's going to happen.
Well, let me double check, because last year, what we did in last year's budget is we did that. We used $50,000 in BP revenue as that placeholder. But let me see if I have that same placeholder.
I mean, that helps us 31 to the good already.
I assume that's what we talked about last year, and I assume that's what we do this year.
But this is actually affecting that.
We want to leverage our BP money to the highest extent and get matching grants, leveraging just a little bit of it. So
yes, now that we did the same thing. I have BP funds loaded into as a revenue stream, so it would not help us offset. No, it would not. We have BP money coming in for that $31,000 just like we did last year. That would not be a place to find savings.
Let me back up to fireworks. Jim, did we ever get any money from TDC on fireworks?
We have invoiced the county. I have not seen anything back. We just we have invoiced.
What were the invoices for?
Now I have.
Yeah, I haven't checked that lately, Jim. This week to see if that's.
We need to check to see if we got. We did probably 2 weeks ago. Yes, we did.
That's correct. Yes, sir. Then page, any other questions on capital?
What about the new tire chain? How important is it, John?
We took that out.
You just got to point, it's been there a long time.
Yeah.
It probably needs to come out.
It needs to come out. All right, I'll take that out, John.
It's not in budget.
The next page 3 is the contingency dollars. You can see we are really low in our contingency dollars, and we have been ever since. The depression in 2009-2008, and we stripped our budgets completely down to manage with the crisis we were in at that time, and we've never built those back up. So those are, especially in streets and highways. John could spend $5,000 and drop of a hat if he has a major road problem. So we're low on our contingency dollars. Grant projects are listed there. We talked about the police department grant dollars. The FDOT, Scott grants from Garrison Avenue, A Street, and Langston.
If we did check on those, they have not awarded anything from FDOT on those two Scott grants, so they still are pending. We have not heard anything about
it. And the FERDAC grant we also talked about, and the Centennial Building we talked about. So those are the general fund grant projects that are out there. The final category in general fund is the non-departmental.
Have we got any money in from anybody, any money at all, since we've been putting on the bills that they won't pass on?
Yeah, we $230-something.
I talked to Jim about that the other day, and I said, well, you know, an idea I thought might work. It's just now a placeholder on the water bill. And,
well, some people won't even recognize that. But I had somebody the other day say, what is this? And I said, you've been getting that for a long time now. And he said, well, I never noticed it.
Yeah.
So I guess some people won't even look at it.
So my comment to him was, let's keep it on there through this budget year, and then I'll bring it up for a meeting and tell them, you take it off, we'll take it off, because it hadn't been raised much interest, I'd hope. If we could give these non-departmentals more money, if we got a few dollars here and there, folks throwing an extra dollar in, but obviously not many are, so.
Yeah, and a lot of people, you got EFTs, they're automatically drafting out. they don't even look at board.
Well, that's true. So anyway, so
Mike, there is one thing. If you go back up to the Langston Drive, this is actually a safe route to school grant. Back in 2013, we applied for it, so 5 years later, it's going to come to fruition this year for sidewalks.
Yeah.
Oh, that's sidewalks?
That's sidewalks, yeah.
Now, under non-departmental, under fireworks donations, where's the $7,000 going to come from in donations?
We've been getting somewhere between 5 and 10 from the county and the TDC, so that's
so your county. That's your county.
Okay. Right, that's not a firm number.
Not really a donation.
It's just a place more
obligation. Well, I think we got 10 from the county from the TDC, but it's...
Some years we do. The last couple of years, we've gotten between five and seven. So each
and I think they pay for the New Year's.
They do pay for the New Year's. So generally what we do is we have a contract for both events. 100% is paid for New Year's Eve, and then the 4th is split.
I know we bought, you're talking about strictly fireworks. I know I'm talking about the pumps that we bought previously. Was that under another fund?
That was under a different fund. Okay. There was actually, last year, there was $10,000 allocated to, I think, the city of Wewichka and the city of Fort St. Joe from the TDC. I have asked, I've not heard anything if that money was in the budget this year or not. We can put it
in. I think they put it in there every year.
Okay. So we may need to send a request out then and decide.
But we need to spend it a certain way. So I'll reach out to Don.
Okay.
I'll
just want to ask a question. I don't want to get nobody in no uproar about it. Humane Society. I've always had animals. I love animals to death. So we're giving them $8,000 to go down here to the Gulf County Library. It helps a lot of our young children growing up, going there for different things. Why don't we give them $4,000? When you explain the difference to me, I'd just like to hear somebody explain that to me. I mean, we think more of animals than we do humans.
The way it's been explained to me, Mr. Mayor, is that the Humane Society, without them, we would incur cost of animal control. Without a library, we would just have less intelligent children. That's how it's been explained to me. So, but I mean, I do think that the library could use a little bit extra money, and I see we've taken, is it 500 that we've taken out?
I think they had requested $4,500 in the motion. Okay.
Can we get that $500 at least back in there so we can work that?
Well, why don't we give them both the same? The Humane Society and the library give library $6,000, Humane Society $6,000, and keep it at $12,000.
Well, you don't think we don't load it on? Chop a head off.
Yeah.
I love animals. I've had animals, but as I say again, I love people more. animals.
That certainly wouldn't impact your bottom line if you didn't.
No, I mean, it's just moving money.
I can tell you, I don't want nothing to do with picking up animals. That's why I feel. Or what we've given them in the past.
Where else can we move a little money just to give the library at least that $500? Can we move $500 from the chamber? We give them $1,500.
I hate to do that. We just got a new guy in there, and I'm here.
Yeah, I thought that seemed to be good.
Yeah.
Well, find me $500, y'all.
I want to find
you. Okay, we can touch it.
$79,000.
That wraps up the general fund. That's a good point. And so we need some guidance from the board on how to move forward with balancing.
Well, I kind of look at this meeting today as just to kind of let everybody know what we need to do. And I feel like everybody needs to go through it over the next week or for our next meeting, and they can get their red pen out and start chopping stuff too.
Well, my unknowns are, of the state first, the increase in health care, I'm always holding firm on maintaining that cap. Health care is going to keep increasing until our government fixes that problem. We can't keep taking on that burden. We'll give a cost of living increase, so because the cost of living goes up, so they can use that extra money to help defray the cost of their health care. So in my mind, you take that $13,794 out of there, and that saves us a little bit right there. And I think that we're also kind of pending the review of our
liability insurance, our property liability casualty.
When PLC insurance comes in, I think we're going to see a substantial savings there, and I'd like to jump from that point and see what we still need to come up with.
I certainly think the next meeting is next Tuesday. Is that right, Jim?
Our meetings are scheduled for next Tuesday. We've been canceled. We have a special workshop, a special meeting next Monday at noon. But the next scheduled budget workshop will be 2 weeks from today, unless you want to have one somewhere in between. Because there's a conference next month.
Well, certainly, at your discretion, we can think about how we're going to balance this thing and go to the next meeting or make some recommendations to us now, whatever.
Well, I want to touch on one subject, if I can. It's the building inspection. I had a meeting with Don Butler, Michael, and Warren Yeager. And I think everybody knows that I'm willing to work with the county. I'm not the kind of guy that thinks every time I turn around the county for who did it. With them different people on the board out there that's willing to work with the city. I think the city needs to work with them. And I have nothing against the guy that does that inspection. Now, if you get along great, that's not the thing. It's just that they are open 4 days a week from 7 in the morning to 5:30. You get your work. You get inspections any of those days. It's going to be a savings to our citizens because the county charges for this. And we get 18% from our current guy. They're agreeing to give us 20% of theirs, which still is money. Not going to be the same because of the difference in the price, but they're going to give us 20% instead of 18 if we want to decide to go that route. And I just think it's something we need to do for our citizens more than anything else. That they shouldn't have to worry about, well, I can't get an inspection today. And, you know, we need to be available to our citizens. The only day it wouldn't be available would be Fridays, but they close on Fridays. Monday through Thursday, as I say, it's 7 in the morning, 5:30 in the afternoon. Jim, I don't know how everybody else feels about this, but we can discuss it now, but I would like it to be put on the agenda for Monday.
Well, Mr. Mayor, I love the idea of, you know, saving that. Let's get some more money back from our building inspector, but I'd like to see an RFQ process done.
Really, yeah,
to participate, because we may have one out there that wants to do it, give us 25%.
There you go, and I agree with that.
Make a competitive process out of it, and let's maybe the county will come up a little bit.
Yeah, I'd like to see some firm numbers about what we get. What we're going to get from the county if we did it, we're giving them all of this inside the city,
right?
And is it going to be an equal give back? In other words, are we going to make at least the same amount of money or more, or are we going to make less money? It is somewhat of a revenue producing for us. So I'd like to see some facts before I make a decision.
Yeah, I'd have to look at this at the county's rates and see if I can come up with a comparison with the 20% of the county rates versus 18%
of
ours.
You
see.
So I understand we're talking dollars.
Right.
Well, I'm talking citizens. They need our help. That's the only reason I'm sitting here.
Sir.
I love our citizens.
It certainly makes
sense. They need help. I'm going to do everything I can to help.
We need to understand the impact.
And I'll say one other thing. City of Tallahassee just had their budget session. They cut 20 city employees to make their budget. They cut 20. There might be some room where we can cut some people. We just need to look at it. Are we overloaded anywhere? I don't know. But I'd like for all of us to look at it and see, can we do without somebody somewhere to save money and still get the job done that we need to get done? So you have to. You have to make some hard decisions in your budget. I mean, Tallahassee make their hard decisions.
Well, I certainly be happy.
They didn't raise taxes, and we're not either. We're going to make some hard decisions if I have anything to do with it.
Well, I'd certainly be happy to look at the numbers just so we understand it and we can make a decision based on what's best overall.
Speak up on that. I understand what the county can offer, and because I see it every day. But I just want everybody to know that I'm going to abstain from that move. One comes.
All right. So then I guess the decision would be to move on to the water fund at this time.
One more thing, man. Go ahead.
Sure.
Come up, okay.
No, I can just talk. I put my teacher voice on. but I am Kathy Colbert. In case any of you don't know, And if you have any questions concerning the library, I would be glad to answer them or to get answers for you. Of course, the county has cut the library in the past few years, and our state finances, when the state looks at what the county cut, they in turn will cut us the next year. So it's not just a small snowball, but it thins as it rolls through, because when that's what they look at, is what does the city give us, what does the county give us, and then they will do the same, especially, and I know times are hard. I understand that perfectly well. But if you should have any questions, or I can do anything, and I'm a little bit like the mayor, I do love our animals, but I do love our children more. As a matter of fact, this Saturday we had a 3D printer workshop for people who wanted to learn to use 3D printers. We have done so much. If you look at the star, little plug in there. But the star has done a wonderful job keeping the citizens of our town updated in all the things that are available out there for our children, from programming to robotics. So it's not just a book place anymore. It's not just a book place. But if you have any specific questions that I can address for you or answer for you, I would be glad to tell you. Thank you.
Ms. Kelly, that was a $500 increase that y'all were requesting.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
I would ask, if y'all are fine, let's throw it back in there.
And
let's
back
at the next, yep. Let's see where we're going to be at and what we're cutting. And,
Mr. Ford, also let me say, and in the past, we did this for the senior citizens. At any time that y'all have a need that comes up in the middle of the year, feel free to come to this board if we can find the money somewhere to help you out.
I appreciate that. So I'm the president of the Friends of the Library, and I have written more grants in the past 8 years than I ever imagined. But grants are like everything else. They get smaller and they get smaller. But yes, I appreciate that so very much.
Thank you.
I would still like to look at the cut back to Humane Society a little bit and pushing it down to the library. That's cut them $1,000 and give it all to the library.
I can go along with that.
I disagree.
I just can't do that.
We're going to end up in the dog catching.
Yeah.
It's not a lot. And we do a lot of on outside of just the budgetary process. So, anyway.
Well, let's put $500 back in there and we'll see what we can have.
Yes, sir.
Anything would be greatly appreciated.
That wraps up the general fund.
I got one more thing I want to keep around in the general fund.
Okay.
This is in the general fund.
Mr. Mayor, I need one. Do you have an extra?
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
For some time, I've been looking at our code enforcement department. I just don't think our citizens are getting what they need to get. I mean, we've got a man that works 20 hours a week. He doesn't have any set hours. Comes in with another job of $1,000 to come in. We also pay him $21 an hour. I got a proposal here I'd like everybody to look at and consider. Code enforcer, hourly pay from $13 to a high of $17 an hour, 28 hours a week. I would like to see a schedule work something like this. First week he works Tuesday through Friday. 7 hours a day. The next week he works Wednesday through Saturday, 7 hours a day. We got a code man on Saturdays, and I think we need one. And as I say, at $15 an hour, we won't save any money. The money will be the same. but we get 416 additional hours per year. That's the main problem I have with our code enforcement department. The only other issue I have, I'd be damned if I know how. Code enforcement working 20 hours a week gets an office in City Hall, and the mayor don't get nothing. And that's a no-brainer to me. I'm working with a lot of people trying to bring jobs to this city, working on different things, developments, and I need an office over here. And that's the only office I never get.
So I thought you had an office in Orange.
Be real.
I'm not.
That's a bunch of crap. I do have an office out there. That's what first they put me right there.
Yeah.
That's what they put me start with, right there. Let me start with that.
I'm not getting an argument.
I just want to explain myself if you'll let me. So then I went out there. Nobody's gonna come way out there to see me. But if I have an office in City Hall, I bet you they will.
Well, you the mayor, kick him out.
Well, I want us to work together. I don't want it just to be me. I want everybody working together. And again, this is for the betterment of our citizens. You get more code enforcement. 416 more hours a year. And get less money.
Well, Mayor,
just like everybody think about it.
I agree that we need the extra hours. Many, many times I've driven by the same house multiple times, had a phone call at the gym or and say, what's going on with it? Well, they've been tagged, that's it. But there's no follow-up a lot of times. And so I think that we do need the extra hours. I don't know if there's just not enough time for it to get it done. But that's a conversation that, you know, maybe Jim could have with code enforcement. What is the issue? Well, why aren't we getting it done?
Can he do paperwork in his vehicle like the police department does, or does he have to have an office to do that?
Some of it does require access to meters, because if you're going to track somebody down with our building system, it's probably the most viable way to do that. Is there a way to do some paperwork in vehicles? Yes, sir.
Yeah, we had looked at moving him out to Public Works, but not having access to Munis was an issue.
Right. But how often does he need Munis?
He uses it on a daily basis when he's in the office.
For what purpose?
For looking at old accounts, getting addresses on the customers, tracking phone numbers.
He could call City Hall and get that information?
Well, it would tax the employees here to be doing his work and their own work, you know.
Right.
So Munis has been the issue with him not being in this building.
Is Munis a local database hosted here? Or is that something on the cloud?
It is. We have the access to move it out to Public Works, but it's spotty service because it's not a direct line, and it's always been problematic.
You need dedicated fiber.
Mm-hmm. And it's expensive to get one of those type of accounts.
Well, how many different offices do we
well,
have?
Well, certainly, we've had Munis on this computer before. That's certainly something we could look at, putting Munis on this computer.
And I don't have a problem with Richie, it's just our citizens. Me and Richie's had our time, don't get me wrong, but we've always worked back. But, now I'm not even coming for us if he can work 20 hours a week and come down to these, offer that $21. I think I've talked to a few cities around, and $21 is too much to pay code enforcement, what they tell me.
Yeah,
they don't pay that.
It's $20.50.
Okay, that's close.
It's close.
That's close. I stand correct.
Yes.
But I just feel like, citizens, we need to do something better. And I would like to have an office in City Hall.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, sir.
I'm going to be late for my next job at 1 o'clock. I've got to excuse myself.
Let's see.
And I'll see y'all in the next budget meeting. Appreciate everyone for coming today.
Okay. Well, I guess that's something we need to put on the next commission meeting then to discuss code enforcement.
Well, if we're talking about a wash, Mr. Mayor, is this something that has to come up during the budget session, this particular position, or is this, we can do this any time?
Yeah,
we
can do it any time.
Right.
Okay. Because it's not going to fit the budget. Well, it's going to work out for $13 an hour, Will.
Sure.
But I figured out that $15 an hour is about the same money.
Right.
Now, we start a lot of people at $13 and, go up to $17. So
with that, then, we've wrapped up the basic discussion on the general fund. We know we need some guidance at the next meeting on how we're balanced. We certainly can come up with some options and present them to you and give you some options on how you think we can balance it. Do we want to continue on with the
water fund.
I had some question on the water fund and wastewater. I don't know if
y'all's kind of there.
I haven't got any other changes.
Yeah, I ain't got nowhere to go.
All right, so page four is the summary of the water fund. The salaries is worked in there as we discussed. The merit of one, there's actually two merits, and that needs to be adjusted. There's two merits in there, that's not correct.
Those will be double that?
Yeah, it'll be double that. The state retirement we talked about, the health insurance plan we talked about, workers' comp.
Yeah, my question is six. We're basing the budget on the rate study recommendation.
Correct.
Because in the last few years, we've decided not to go up as much, but we have gone up. So if we're going up, we're basing this $60,000 under water fund and under wastewater. There's 80,000. So in essence, we're going up 6.5% on our utilities for the upcoming year, which might get some folks a little riled up. But we're basing a budget on that, so we're going to have to leave it and take flak, or we're going to have to find ways to again find some. All it'll do is add to our red number if we don't stick with this.
Certainly, we've based the rate increase on our rate study.
Right.
We've been following the rate study. We took a lot of great effort in that rate study to make sure we were covering our future capital needs.
Exactly.
and make sure we were covering our debt obligations with both the SRF and with our regional loan.
I mean, I think it's important we've got to cover our debt loads, but. So anyway, I thought I'd better.
It's certainly taxing on our citizens. There's no question about it. But staff's position is that we don't want to make any adjustments without a careful review of our future, and that requires a rate study. In our opinion, I mean, we've established a process that works to ensure the financial health of the community long term, and we don't want to see us go back to short term decision making. But it's certainly, we all agree, it's difficult for all of us. We all pay those bills, but it's substantial, and we'd love to do what we can. And we certainly think moving towards our refinancing in a few years and being able to pay down our debt, it should be a target of ours, and to try to find some relief for the rate increases for our citizens.
Yeah, I know Jim and I met with Ralph Seedlin couple different times and seeing if we could do some refinancing, but he even said, well, right now you need to sit tight because it's as good as it could be right now.
Yeah.
So.
Your current plan is a 5-year plan that you have in place done by ordinance. I think it goes through 2018, if I'm not mistaken.
That's correct.
And what we usually do is when we're getting close to that period in time, what we do is we bring the rate study people back in again to evaluate where we're at with our financials on there to give us a recommendation. Okay, do we hold the line? Do we need to reduce it? Do we need to go up? The trend, luckily, since we've had the rate study people come in place, I think it was 2010, I think it was the first year we brought.
That's correct.
Burton Associates in. Guys, I think we were at a 17% increase, so it was off the charts. And now we've got it down to minuscule. Is there a little bit of an increase in there? Yes, there is an increase in there. But we're finally heading in the right direction because we're starting to see an increase in customer base. So we're getting close to that, getting back to par.
How is our growth compared to what the study showed that we should be at?
The customer usage and growth numbers are right on track. They're within a percent of the estimated calculation from 3 years ago, which is pretty good. We are missing the mark, you can believe it or not, on the impact fees and the new. We were really aggressive on the growth rates for new construction and impact fee growth. So we're missing the mark by about 20 units right now this year, and we projected additional growth. And part of that hurts us is that we're seeing a lot of the growth in the Cape, which is sewer only, and we're not seeing as much here in the city and on the beaches. But as far as the estimate on our revenue projections, it's right on spot on.
with what we're seeing. So the usage numbers are there, but our new construction growth numbers are a little under projection.
I tell you, I mean, just word on the street, it sounds like a group that's going to be taking over phase two of some construction in Newmark is going to come to fruition. So that'll help.
No question that would save us significantly and help us to do in our next rate study. If we can see some substantial growth in that area, that would help us substantially.
Those are those prepaid, in fact, these though out in that phase two?
That they are prepaid.
But
in that,
we still must look at the monthly
revenue and the ad valorem dollars is where we really need that growth in the general fund. So we all agree that it's difficult on our citizenry, but our position is that it's vital to continue the process that we started and to make sure financial security. And that brings us then to the capital items listed. Water distribution, we talked about the road bond money. Water system improvements and is an item that we plugged in last year to augment any potential shortage that we may have in that Long Avenue project or for other capital items that come up. We didn't want to specify, we wanted to generalize those dollars to give John flexibility in case something comes up. And one of those issues that has come up is the third item there is water system meters. We have $50,000 in the budget, and we've worked with consultants to try to look at what we can do to improve our water meters and to replace and our entire system. And John, I don't know if you or Jim want to speak to any of that.
Trying to put together a plan for you. Basically, what we have is we've been living on a warranty piece that we've had for our meters. Past, we had a problem, we could call them to get replacement meters. Our senior warranty phases up. So now what we're seeing is we get what's called a stop meter report. So we're starting to see our meters are starting to die slow death, so to speak. Right now our stop meter report showed about 400 meters. Now, not all those are meters that are dying, because what you got to remember is a lot of those are large meters. Those are not radio read meters. All the towns, those kind of areas, are going on. Probably half of those are still might be manually read. What does this mean? It means that now all 400 of them have to be manually read. So what we want to do is we want to continue to replace these meters in here, because time is money and money's time. But yes, can we still go out there and manually read those, and are we doing it? Yes, we are doing that. But at the same time, we still would like to have the radio read feature in there where we can ride around and have guys doing other things besides having to read meters.
Well, and it's not just the radio read. I mean, you know, when we first got into the new meters 10 years ago, you know, they were somewhat new technology. It wasn't, you know, brand new, but it wasn't, you know, tested as well. And they've worked well, but it's not just the radio read itself, but other functions of the meter, the cataloging, you know, when someone has a leak or a complaint, you know, that's a feature that we're losing as well. So, you know, the 423 represents those that just stop reading from a radio perspective, but there's, you know, double, triple that and lost other functions. And it's just based on age. They're not meant to last forever, maybe not. Improvements over the last 10 years have been made. So, you know, it's just something that we need to put on the plate and think about, you know, that if we're going to continue, which water is very important, we need to make sure that we can collect off every ounce we have.
So, brand new. Yeah.
And in order to do that, these registers and these meters are going to fail, you know, over time. They're just not meant to last. So, you know, we've talked about this from staff level for, you know, a few weeks now, and have been, you know, trying to gather, you know, information. So, you know, we can't afford a full system replacement. So the only other avenue would be a phased approach. You know, it would have to be, you know, sectionalized out until we get replaced and you start back over again.
So the plan was that wanted 600K to replace all of them. We don't have that money. The thought was, let's place one third, and replace all of our meters over a 3-year period, pay for them up front, and the lifeline on those was about 10 years. So we figured we would have 6 years, 7 years there.
for years to replace our system, and then the good quality of use for 6 or 7 years before we would have to look at our system again.
When you say replace all, you're just talking about the ones that are not reading now, or the entire system?
No, we're talking about replacing the entire system.
But what we're talking about is we do it as a phased approach, pinpoint a specific area, more likely somewhere in town. We'll always meter out, and then the ones that are still operational, we could use those in other places that are failing, you know, out within your distribution system.
It's also a thought that by doing this, having consistency in meters, we could potentially significantly increase our revenue stream. It would also force us to do an inventory of our system, potentially finding holes in our system where we're missing existing meters that are out there. So it's a way for us to do an inventory and to ensure that we have maximum revenue stream from our water, which is certainly vital to us being able to capitalize on our assets.
Well, we're continuing to work it. Probably the next budget meeting we'll have some more concrete information for you, but that's our thinking right now is that we put some money towards it this year, do it as a phased approach, that way we're not having to borrow anything. There is some options to lease, but I can't recommend that we pay that kind of interest in this budget.
So that's the water meter issue there. Do we discuss the SRF? Haven't we just said SRF $250,000? That's the existing from carryover for phase three. That SRF $250,000
in the downtown section.
That's the downtown section. That's right. The CDBG grant for Northport St. Joe, Northwest Florida grant for Northport St. Joe, two of them, gooseneck trailer, and another excavator.
Did we buy an excavator last year, a small one? We did not.
It's
two years old now.
Certainly the reasoning behind, I think John can speak to it,
I'll be glad to. Because more or less questions on here. I mean, the idea, you know, behind the other excavator is not just for projects in general, you know, utility projects to assist and help us, but there's been a lot of functions the last several years. You know, we became heavier and heavier in the construction aspect.
You know, no question about it, yeah.
And in doing that, what we've also done is we've fallen behind on routine maintenance items.
Yep. I can see the need for it. You know, we go to Cape and start doing more out there.
We've got repairs, you know, to existing utilities we have to, you know, perform. You know, as well as ditch maintenance, you know, yeah, stormwater, and you know, those are just things that you have to have in a piece of equipment like this for.
Sure.
So we've got two great operators in the city, you know, and we just need the equipment to run your work.
We're saving a lot of money doing it ourselves. So
we're saving a lot of money.
Yeah.
We haven't qualified that, but if we did, I'm sure it'd be substantial.
Yeah. For a little city, we're pretty self-sufficient. Yeah. Honestly, that's kind of rare for a small city.
And you'll see that excavator across the other funds and spread it out because he uses it for multiple purposes.
Well, John, if you can fix our drainage issues, I'll support this 100%.
Well, I can tell you, we will definitely work on it. If you can make it stop raining more,
And then the water plant, the membrane filters, and water plant improvements, and then mowers for the water plant, the capital item system.
Which filters, if you recall, last year we replaced one set of filters. You have four sets of filters at the water plant. We were hoping to replace more than one set this year, but we definitely got in one. We'd love to do more, but it's just we don't know how to get there.
Quit breaking stuff, Larry. We'll have more money.
And then that contingency funds, again, you know, those aren't, this $30,000 for those is low. Our contingency dollars are low. And then the grant funds, we talked about all of those items. They're listed for you there. So that wraps up the water fund. Any other discussion on water? The solid waste. Again, we'll discuss those items. The number three is the tipping fees. The lay down yard has reduced those costs significantly. We don't take very much at all to the landfill.
That's still functioning somewhat, does the gentleman still come and?
We actually have to, it's getting close to calling in for another round. We've got more than him to call this year.
Yeah, I'm just afraid that when he goes away, where are we going to be? Hopefully there'll be somebody to pick up slack.
We had some additional contacts given to us from FDEP that folks do work like that. So, you know, there'll be more than just one individual call.
Good.
But at this point, yes, it is. So,
yeah, 7 is a lot of money.
All right, 10 fees.
Yes. The solid waste has been balanced this year to date, even with that loss of the $33,000 in revenue from the Waste Pro. I didn't list that there, but it was discussed on the first page of revenue producers or transfer stations. So the solid waste is clicking along and seems to be working. And that contract we discussed earlier is another 2 years on the garbage hauling and Waste Pro.
Something else we haven't discussed too is looking at that 5-year CIP plan. Some of that equipment's getting some age on too.
It is.
That's something we're going to think about in a couple of years. That plant truck, jail truck, and the dump truck is huge.
And we've worked that into our capital, 5-year capital expense plan, if I'm not mistaken. That we'll present to you or put in your boxes. All right, then the wastewater fund. In the first two, three items.
Lay down yard on the solid waste. We're not talking about that for a while unless we just have to. Lay down yard concrete pad.
Oh, yeah.
Until we absolutely have a gun to our head.
So in the wastewater fund, we've talked about all of those items there. Number five, as Commissioner talked about, is a significant increase to our sewer.
I have a question about solar bees. How many years we have left on that lease?
I think that's two. This year and one more.
December 2018 for your last payment.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then from there we would go to just a maintenance agreement of I think $5,000 or $6,000 or something like that,
right,
where they would do 100% maintenance on or significant maintenance.
Right. They cover the units.
Sure.
So things that go, those kind of units is panels and batteries, and panels are, instead of 25-year life, basically batteries they say is about a 5-year life.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll try to get the batteries replaced just before we run out of lease.
And if you look on the one section there, list the lagoon lease versus electrical expense savings, we've saved, I haven't updated, that's last year's number. But it is, I think, over $75,000 significant savings.
Instead of running those big time areas.
Back 10 years ago, what was that, Mike? Somewhere around
$400,000. $400,000 in electrical expenses.
Yeah.
We've cut that down to 120, I think it is.
We still have some of those operational loads.
We have three that may be functional.
Yeah.
The power supply, the whole power grid is shot.
That's what I remember.
So the cost of replacing the power grid was over $1 million in our first estimate. So that's one of the reasons why we chose this process is you just can't afford to keep feeding a bear like that.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it seems to be working. We get what we need out of these guys. It's just crazy not to.
Yeah.
Then the capital items you listed there, the repowering the wastewater plant and permits, and then wastewater collection, so lift station improvements. We just generalized those. Historically, we've said this lift station or that. We just generalized those lift stations. We know that our lift stations are a significant issue for us, and they're going to have to be addressed and improved. And John's got a good chunk of money in there to take care of some of those issues in this next budget cycle. We talked about the road bond money and then augmenting the road bond money with that $468,000. And then also potentially, if John's crew can ever finish all of these projects he's on, to go back to the Cape and try to keep extending lines on the Cape to try to increase our customer base out there as a way to increase our revenue stream and then help us to reduce our debt.
and reduce our rates increases.
We're a total of a 6.5 rate increase, count sewer and water.
Yes, it's 2.7, 2.5, and 3.7.
It was a 6.5 in my half.
Yeah, 6.5.
I can put together an impact for a customer number for you if you'd like to see that. So that is all of the summary of the budget as it's presented to you today, and certainly have put some good time and effort into it, and certainly see anything in any of the detail. Anybody has any questions in any of the detail, we certainly would be happy to field any questions in any of the detail.
As far as the next meeting, do we want to plan on 2 weeks from today at noon, or is it a good time for us to get back together?
Won't be here.
Okay, whatever, 2 weeks from today. 22nd.
22nd.
22nd. Next week, we'll have several folks out of town next week. We do have our special meeting next Monday at noon. That will be out at the Woodridge.
I'm fine with you.
Did we talk about having a budget before that meeting?
We had one tentatively on the 15th, but we have time for this
on the 15th, but we canceled our regular meeting.
Right, okay. I haven't gotten the 22nd.
Yeah, we
have.
Well,
what's
the
24th,
that is a Thursday.
I'm fine with them.
I got company in town. My sister coming from South Carolina. She wanted me to be with her. Since she broke her hip, she's still coming.
Thursday's
fine. Trying to get her
to stay home. 24th, I don't know.
Will that work for everybody?
Yes, sir.
I appreciate it. We can move it to that.
We're going to do it at noon?
Yes, that's fine.
Are you
ready? I'm 24th at noon, so that's fine.
All right, any other questions or comments?
All right, something I'd like to start with.
Gentlemen, I know this is a preliminary review of the budget, and it's just a work in process, and I appreciate the time and effort that you're putting into it. But Commissioner Lowry has already addressed it. I think a 400% increase in commissioners' compensation is outlandish. Granted, it's been over 20 years since there's been any increase at all. And in 20 years, that would be a 60% increase if you gave the same cost of living increase that you're giving employees, which would equate to around $180, $500 a month. I don't think anybody would object to that. You spend your gas going around, you do things. I understand that. But to go from 1,000 to 1,300 plus with the cost of living increases, this city can't afford that. In the future, if my taxes go up, I don't know that I can afford them. One time in my life I made good money, I'm not anymore. I'm semi-retired. A 400% increase is just ludicrous. And I'm also concerned about the way I see the city commission doing things. A 400% increase proposed in the budget, and I understand that, and I hope common sense will prevail. But in the last year, y'all have allowed city employees to take time off work to go do their school board and their county business. I think one of the employees has had an excess of 20 days off. 20 days off, that's 4 weeks. If you've got an employee you can do without 4 weeks, you need to look at that real hard. That's you just don't need somebody if they're out 4 weeks. Somebody's sick, understand that. But to take time off on some other job that they're being compensated for, highly compensated. I just don't understand it. Give them time off unpaid? Fine. I don't think anybody would disagree with that. That would be encouraging and following. But to pay them, plus them get paid from their other job, is just not acting in your fiduciary responsibility to safeguard our tax dollars. I understand three of you are going to the League of Cities meeting next week. Why three? Why not the city manager and one employee have them, one commissioner, come back and say, hey, this is what's going on. This is something we need to look into. But three people, I guess it's going to cost you somewhere around $5,000 to the city. That would be $2,500 to the Humane Society, $2,500 more to the library. I'm really concerned about the path that I see happening. And I hope that in this budget and in y'all's future deliberations, you will take that into consideration. You said earlier that some of the people that voted you think you need to be made more money. I voted for you, and you don't need a 400% raise.
You voted for me?
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
And just to address this, you know, what you said about the employee getting paid, when we made that commitment, we knew we were going to probably have to tweak it some. And we're working on that now as far as tweaking it, to where you just don't take time off anytime you want to, that you pick and choose the most events that you think you'll get the most out of. So we know we're going to have to tweak that some.
But I have not heard any city commission discussion of it.
Right. We won't have our meeting with it.
I watch it on the internet, and I don't see it.
We had it when we voted on it.
Well, yeah, that was when we voted on it. But it's been long enough now that it needs to be changed. And again, I'll reiterate, giving them unpaid time off without any consequences, that's one thing. But giving them paid time off, if it was a charitable organization they were working for, that's a different thing. But they're being compensated. Nicely compensated.
So we presented you with the budget there, and we look forward to your guidance and moving forward. And if you have any questions, please contact Jim or I or any department heads if you have any questions about their general budgets, and move forward with our meeting on the 22nd.
You know, just one more thing on the raises. I'm willing to negotiate. You know, maybe something a little less. You know,
as a voter and a taxpayer in the city, actually it's a 420% raise. I would not be in favor of that.
Right.
But if you look back, the 3% a year for 20 years, a 60% increase, I would vote for that.
Right. We'll have to work on this and we'll come up with it.
We can put some numbers together for you.
And also,
if it goes to the other, I might think that I'll run for office.
I know, you do too. They come out of the woodwork.
Speaking of our next meeting, I know it's incumbent on us to look for ways to save balance this budget. We got $69,000.
Yes, sir.
Plus 500 in both, looking for the library.
Yes, sir.
So, any suggestions you guys have, it would be helpful, but short of those suggestions I threw out, we need to look at other places I can get.
Well, it's tough with the $60,000 swing in the balance on our property liability. I'd love to see what that number comes back to, what we accept.
But you got to remember, your raise is going on forever, and that $60,000 may come back bite in the butt next year when liability goes up. So that's not ever.
One thing about changing insurance companies. Unfortunately, I was on the city commission when we voted to go to United Healthcare for the healthcare provider. That was the biggest boondoggle I have ever voted for in my life. So be careful, and you have some, even if you have to pay somebody outside to come in and look at these proposals, make sure you're getting what you, because we didn't, and I felt sorry for the city employees. I really did, because we did a disservice to them for 1 year.
I think both cities and the county ran into that issue.
We did out of necessity more than anything else.
Yeah.
The cheapest option.
Well, when you experience a 20% increase at one time, what do? You just try to make it work.
We'll certainly get those workers' comp and liability insurance numbers nailed down, and we'll work together with staff and try to come up with some options to make this thing work. But I think we're fairly close.
Cool. All right.
Anything else today?
Thank you, gentlemen.
See y'all later.
All help is appreciated.
See you later.
Love you, Jim.
We all voted for you last time, didn't we?
Yeah, last time. Oh, not what he was talking about. He wasn't talking about the first time.
No.
Yes, sir, right here.
I ran over there.
Looks like the culprit umbrella.
It must be Miss Candace.
Grab a bite to eat. Come back for another meal. Don't have a good one, guys.
All right, everybody.
See y'all later.
Where was your dog at? Was that already in there? Or?
I don't know.
I didn't see it in there.
It wasn't on the thing.
I thought he had it in there. Did he quit? Mike, was the dog in there?
What? Yes.
Yeah, I thought training, it was. Yeah,
it's in there. A police officer in training.
Both are in there right now.
But separate items?
Yeah.
No, there's no dog. We're noted separately.
The dog is not on this.
It's not on that page.
It's in the body of the expenses.